after 14 years, in spite of what the AO had said, and after having opened the L1's bid, oh, the bid and the L1 came out of it, for having not procured, don't the UPA government's representatives and the Congress party's leaders owe an answer to this country on the armed forces preparedness? Now they are bickering over the price. And I will still answer, even on price, we have obtained a deal for the 36 which is far better than what they would have obtained per aircraft. But the fact is, after having spent that long, after having opened the L1, you did not even recognize that the whole thing started off because you wanted to give enough strength to the Air Force. Have they served the cause, or have they done a disservice to the nation's armed forces preparedness? I think to bicker on the cost, which I can any time prove that we would pay a better price, but to bicker on that as though they have served the interest of the preparedness and we are not doing it is, I'm sorry to say, it's in sharp words, shameful. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Undoubtedly. Absolute baseless argument. Not a single procedure has been violated. As I said, it is an intergovernment agreement for which the Cabinet Committee on Security's clearance has been obtained, post which the intergovernment agreement has been signed after maybe 5 rounds of discussion between the visit of the Prime Minister and the day when it was signed in September 2016. So for an intergovernment agreement, which is, as I said, allowed by procedure, and for the 5 rounds of discussions which got reported to the Cabinet Committee on Security, post which the approval of the CCS was obtained, post which the agreement was done in full public view with the 2 defense ministers of France and India being there, has been done. Absolutely no procedure has been violated. Mike. The contrast is, they didn't arrive at the conclusion. Whether for 126 or for 36, we've shown that we've moved forward and also clearly signed an agreement. That itself tells you that this government takes decision even in complex and sensitive matters like defense. And both my eminent predecessors, Shri Manohar Parikar and Arun Jaitley, have made the systems work smoothly and speedily. So, and even this allegation, if anything, is politically motivated because they are unable to find any corruption allegation against this government, so just throw questions without even doing their fundamental homework on the topic. That's exactly what they've done. There's nothing that is going to stick on this government because everything is being done transparently and as per procedure. So that question itself, I would want you to please reframe if you would want to ask it anytime, anywhere else, that there's just no comparison between the ways in which UPA took decisions and the way in which NDA takes decisions, because we have made both simpler, smoother, faster, above all, transparent. Decisions are being made. Within the first 3 years itself, we've made decisions. Unlike the 14 years or 10 years between 2004 and 14 that the UPA led, which were full of everyday reports of scams and indecision. नहीं, कंपैरिजन करने में ज्यादा अच्छा तब होगा जब डिसीशन उस समय भी हुई और इस समय भी डिसीशन हो रही है. जब डिसीशन ही नहीं हुआ क्या कंपैरिजन करेंगे आप? प्राइस के ऊपर अगर आप कंपेयर करेंगे तो मैं यही भी बोल रही हूँ आपके सामने कि तब की प्राइस और अब की प्राइस में हम ये स्पष्ट बोल सकते हैं कि अभी जो प्राइस अराइव हुआ है सिर्फ 36 का, अगेन कंपेरिजन अगर आप 126 के साथ करेंगे वो भी गलत होगा. फिर 36 का और वे 36 के लिए अर्जेंट एंड इमरजेंसी बेस्ड प्रोक्योरमेंट के लिए हमने माना सीसीएस के अप्रूवल के साथ कि टीओटी का आवश्यकता नहीं हो सकता है और आवश्यकता जोड़िए उससे हमें लाभ नहीं मिलेगा, देश का नुकसान ही होगा, क्योंकि 36 के लिए अगर टीओटी के रास्ते पे आप जाओगे उससे प्राइस अनावश्यक रूप में ज्यादा होगा, कम नहीं होगा. अगर 126 का परचेस और 36 का परचेस का तुलनात्मक कुछ करेंगे वो भी गलत होगी. इसीलिए मैं ये मानकर चल रही हूँ इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन को मानते हुए हमारे डिसीजन हुआ और 36 के साथ टीओटी इसीलिए नहीं जोड़ा और 36 का प्राइस पर एयरक्राफ्ट का प्राइस का बेसिस में हम बात करें तो हमने जो प्राइस ले आए एडिशंस के साथ वो बहुत ही कम है अगर रफली आप एनडीए यूपीए के समय का प्राइस से आप कंपेयर करेंगे तो. नो, प्राइम मिनिस्टर डिड नॉट साइन द इंटर गवर्नमेंट अग्रीमेंट. इट डिडंट हैपन इन पेरिस, इट हैपेंड इन दिल्ली. No, may not have been the L1, assume that that statement is right. We've gone on an intergovernmental agreement for the sake of the kind of discussion which the Congress party is throwing at us. I'm referring to the so-called L1 of those days. It is an intergovernmental agreement we have gone with, where for 10 years of negotiation had happened. And assume it was not established, we had gone definitely with an intention of meeting with an emergency situation. I'm also giving this historical background of what happened during those 10 years, where somebody was L1, where somebody was not L1, the minister 10 years later, assume 10 years later has left it inconclusive. What does it say? 10 years of negotiation. 10 years of negotiation, you receive tenders, and then you say whether that one is doable or not. What does it say of the government? I'm sorry. If you are trying to pinpoint on something now, say, how did you know that that was the L1? Even that minister had left it like that. I want to ask you, 10 years later, that minister said he's not sure. If he had said it, and I'm sure my senior predecessor had spoken about it. I'm saying, what does it give us an image of a government which spent 10 years talking to one or probably two companies? Would we apply our mind on that? And it is that same party today who tells me something is seriously wrong here. 10 years you spoke, let's say, with one or two companies. You don't know who is L1. And that party today asks me a question on an intergovernmental agreement. Would you see the gravity of it? Please. First of all, I'm not commenting on anything which my predecessor, Sri Anthony, would have said in the file or would not have said in the file. I'm not commenting on it. First. Second, I'm not aware of any stumbling blocks. We wanted quickly, in flyaway condition, aircrafts which would serve us in a situation where we wanted to replenish quickly. And that's what happened. 5 rounds after the Prime Minister agreed to process this Rafael deal, and after that, the technical experts, people from Air Force, had 5 rounds of talks, and after that, in September 2016, the agreement, which is an intergovernmental agreement, was signed. I'm not aware of any stumbling blocks there. Discussion. All right, we will, I'm not running away from giving you specific numbers. We will give you. I have both the Defence Secretary and also Mr. Nambiar, who can give you the details. But what I would want to present here is the facts are absolutely before you. And in a minute, I'll ask both of them to respond in terms of the numbers which you want to take. But the discussions were held in India. The seriousness of the situation, and here it pains me to say, that every time we are talking about these procurement, particularly after the UPA has spent 10 years recognizing there is a need for us to quickly get this reinforced for the Air Force, allegations are being thrown, numbers are being asked, numbers, I don't mind about the cost and the amount which is being paid, agreed to be paid, because those are public money, but about number of aircrafts, what will that mean in terms of squadron? And who are we revealing these facts for? We will tell you. The parliamentary committees are also asking us. Several questions on this have also been answered in the parliament by the defence minister and by the Raksha Rajya Mantri. So, it pains me to think that in the name of transparency, I'm fully willing to discuss the cost, the money which is being spent and so on. Repeatedly we are talking about squadron, squadron strength. Anyway, you'll get it in parliament. But intention is what? To strengthen our armed forces or anything else? Anyway, Secretary, would you want to comment anything on specific figures? That is what we are getting the figures, if you want. Secretary, would you want to
comment? You tell us what exactly comparative data you want, we'll give you the data.
Sorry? Complying with the agreement which has been made. We are not violating, bypassing of that agreement at all. We will abide by every bit of that agreement which has been signed, the intergovernmental agreement, in which offset is also one of the clauses. I'm not trying to bypass it. We are not trying to ignore it. It is not violative at all. We will do it. But what made the discussions, why did we not carry on? 10 years. You didn't come to a conclusion. No. You want to see something beyond, I can't see anything beyond sitting here. 10 years of negotiation, they had resulted in nothing. And after that, you want me to protract the negotiation and again go on, because after signing the contract, it still is going to take time. Will I continue with this negotiation for whatever reason it is protracted for 10 years? Which is not, I suppose, government is a continuity. I might have to explain why 10 years spent by UPA, but yes, very quickly we wanted to get as many as we can possibly, so that the urgent need will be taken care of. Yes, if you can obtain all the 126 in fly-off condition within a year or two after the signing of the contract, we could have. But what was feasible? What is quick? Urgent requirement to be met? These were the considerations. I don't know, I can't nod my head on any of these figures. No, that's okay. Even then, I'm keeping my caution, because I will give you the figures you want. But I mean